Howdy, TUBALCAIN again to talk to you a little bit about some parts of a lathe. This is the apron off of a South Bend 10-inch lathe. I believe it's a 10-inch, but it is definitely a South Bend. And the apron is a portion of the carriage that is down below the ways, and it's really where most of the controls are for the lathe while you're operating it, other than the cross feed and the compound. But it's interesting to see how this is made. This, of course, is the carriage hand wheel that moves the carriage back and forth on the ways. This is the feed change lever. It has three positions. The top is for the longitudinal feed, the middle is for threading, and the bottom is for the cross feed. And this is the clutch knob used for power feeds. And this, of course, is the threading lever, sometimes also known as the half nut lever or the split nut lever. It's used strictly for threading. It's a very positive drive. Should you crash the lathe during the threading operation, you generally damage something, usually a gear. Some lathes have a shear pin. The clawsing has a shear pin to protect that. But looking on the back side here, this is something you don't get to see unless you have your lathe apart. But this is the half nut that I was just describing, or split nut. And I'm going to put this feed change lever in the middle position, and you're going to see now that when I move the threading lever up and down, it closes the half nut, or opens it, whichever operation you're doing. And that's the lead screw goes through here, and of course it's just clamping over the lead screw. Now, when you're doing traditional feeding with the carriage hand wheel right here, what's actually happening is you're turning this gear, and this gear rides on the rack. Now, the rack is a straight gear that is underneath the lathe bed, under the ways, and that is how you're actually turning it when you are moving the carriage, when you turn the carriage hand wheel. Okay, now I'll show you what happens when you use the longitudinal feed. We put the feed change lever into the top position, and now the half nut lever is deactivated. It cannot be used, and the power will be transmitted through the clutch. Now, looking at the back side, the clutch is in this section here, and we're not going to really talk about how that works, but it's a little clutch that has plates in it, something like what maybe a car has. Now, again, the lead screw goes all the way through here, but if you examine the lead screw, you'll see that there's a keyway running from one end to the other. Now, I'm going to put this wooden plug in here, and I put a taper on the end of it, and now I'm turning this and simulating the lead screw on the lathe. And at this point, I'm going to tighten the clutch, and as I turn this, well, you can see that the carriage hand wheel is turning, but also at the same time, this little gear is turning, and it's riding on the rack, and it will be moving the carriage left to right or right to left, depending on how you have set your feed reverse lever over on the headstock end. So that's how the longitudinal feed works. Now, in this last segment, I'm going to show you how the cross feed works on this apron. We put the feed change lever into the bottom position, and that is for cross feed. And then I've tightened the clutch. And again, I'm simulating with this wooden stick what the lead screw would do. And I forgot to mention, I told you that the lead screw has a keyway running from one end to the other. Well, there's a corresponding key in the back of this, and that's what drives it. The thread is not driving it for the feeds. The thread is only driving the carriage for threading. This prevents unnecessary wear on the actual thread. So you should never use the threading feature for feeding. Some people do that, but that's not a good practice. Anyway, now as I turn this, lead screw, you can see that this gear on the top is slowly moving, and that is transmitting the power from the lead screw through the gears and up into the bottom of the cross slide, and moving the cross slide either away from you or toward you, again depends on how you have your feed reverse lever set. This is a very heavy piece. It's all cast iron, very high quality, and if you've ever taken the cheaper lathes apart, such as an Atlas, you'll see that this is so superior. This is cast iron, not as replaceable, but it is fitted up in a dovetail, and you can imagine how expensive that must be to do. And it is oiled by putting it in this Gitz oiler, and then it would run here and kind of drip on down and find its way into this hole. And over here you can see that there are little wicks that this little tray fills with oil, and that the oil is wicked to the various parts that you can't get at with a squirt oil gun. Hope you enjoyed this little session talking about a South Bend lathe, which is to me the best lathe for a home use. Quite expensive, even a used one. They don't make them anymore. The firm is out of business. This is TUBALCAIN saying so long for now. Be sure and watch my many other videos.